Welcome all of you in this tutorial of random forest. First of all, we see why we need random forest. So let's see. Bias and variance. The optimal model should maintain the balance between two errors, that is bias and variance. When there is a error in bias and variance in our model, then we have to overcome this problem. This problem is overcome by using ensemble technique like bagging, boosting, stacking and blending. Here we can see our optimal models here. Having low bias and low variance can be obtained by using ensemble technique like bagging, boosting, stacking and blending. And random forest is one of the bagging technique. That's why we have to use bagging for better result and better understanding of our model. So let's see what is random forest. Random forest is supervised machine learning algorithm that can be used for both classification and regression. Random forest is similar to bagging technique. And when random forest is just like a bagging techniques, but difference is that we use best learner as a decision tree. So this is the required difference between bagging and random forest. Let's see the steps for random forest. In random forest, we create multiple bootstrap sample by using method of rows with replacement, and we also do the random feature selection in these bootstrap samples. That is, we select randomly select variables from the dataset and create a decision tree model on each of the bootstrap sample. And again, finally, in third step, we combine the prediction of all decision trees, just like bagging. When there is a problem of classification, we use majority of votes as our combining technique. Combining as we combine final prediction. When there is a classification problem, then we use majority of vote. And when there is a regression problem, then we take mean or median of our predicted values. So let's see the in deep what is bootstrap sampling and random feature selection in random forest. Let's see here. Let's assume that our 12 rows, that is 12 data points containing data set, and this data set containing 5 variables. So let's see, this is the first bootstrap sample, this is the second bootstrap sample, this is the third bootstrap sample, nth bootstrap sample. We can make multiple bootstrap samples from a single dataset. This sampling is with replacement, that is we can say rows with replacement. And again, one thing is that in each bootstrap sample there is a feature selection also, that is variable selection also. Let's as we assume that this variable, these 12 rows contain 5 variables. In this dataset we have 5 variables. Then we can say that first variable, second variable and fifth variable can be selected in first bootstrap sample. First variable, second variable and third variable can be selected in second bootstrap sample. As like that, feature selection, that is variable selection, is taken randomly in random forest. There is a bootstrap sampling also, as well as feature selection also in the bootstrapping. So let's see the algorithm, that is flowchart of our random forest, how random forest work actually. This is the flowchart of random forest. Let's see, this is the data set. Let's say that this data set contain 200 rows, that is 200 data points and 10 variables. We can make multiple random sample like this, this and this. We can make multiple bootstrap samples from our data set by using feature selection as well as bootstrapping, like rows with replacement. Let's see, we take size of our bootstrap sample as 100. Then from these 200 rows, we select 100 rows randomly in each bootstrap sample, as well as out of 10 variables from our this data set, we can select randomly some variables, that is feature selection. We can say first variable, second variable, fifth variable, sixth variable and seventh variable can be selected in first bootstrap sample. Then again फर्स्ट वेरिएबल, सेकंड वेरिएबल, थर्ड वेरिएबल, फोर्थ वेरिएबल, फिफ्थ वेरिएबल कैन बी सिलेक्टेड इन सेकंड बूटस्ट्रैप सैंपल. लाइक दिस वी कैन सिलेक्ट मल्टीपल रोज विथ रिप्लेसमेंट, दैट इज रोज विथ रिप्लेसमेंट सैम्पलिंग एज वेल एज फीचर सिलेक्शन. दिस टू थिंग्स आर हैपनिंग इन फर्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ बूटस्ट्रैपिंग इन रैंडम फॉरेस्ट. अगेन वी अप्लाई सेपरेटली एंड इंडिपेंडेंटली a decision tree on each bootstrap sample. Here we can see this is first bootstrap sample, this is the first decision tree, this is the second bootstrap sample, this is the second decision tree, this is the nth bootstrap sample, this is the nth decision tree. These decision tree are independent from each other, independently it is applied on each bootstrap sample, and again at final step we combine all the prediction of each decision tree and we make a final model, that is strong model. This is, these are the weak base learners and this is the strong learner. Final prediction predicted model, that is final model, is our strong learner. Let's see when we train it on our trained data set, and again when we apply our test data set. Let's say our test data set is putted in this each random each bootstrap sample. When our test data set is going in this and we apply first decision tree, our test data set is going in second bootstrap sample and we apply this second decision tree. Like this, when our test data set is going through all decision trees, that is all bootstrap samples decision tree, when there is a when our data set contains classification problem, then our target variable gives, when there is a binary class problem, that is we have two classes like 0 and 1. Let's say our first decision tree gives our answer is 1, our second decision tree gives answer as a 1, and third decision tree gives answer as a 0. Then there is a, in final model there is a majority of voting, like first two decision tree gives answer 1 and third decision tree gives answer 0. That's why we select our answer is 1, because 1 is there for 2 times and 0 is there for only once. That's why majority of voting, that's why we say that our answer is 1. And in regression model, we take mean or median of all prediction, that is prediction from first decision tree, prediction from second decision tree, prediction from n decision tree. We take aggregate, that is we take mean or median of all decision tree results as in regression problem and make final prediction. As like this we do random forest. Random forest is nothing but bagging technique. There is a difference is that there is only change in bootstrap sample is taken like same as bagging, but there is a feature selection also, as well as we apply decision tree only in as a base learner and we obtain a final our optimal model using those decision tree. So we use random forest because of there is a problem in the bias and variance. When we apply multiple decision tree, then there is reduction in variance. When we apply single decision tree, then there is variance in our output is output and original data, original target variable and our predicted target variable is high. There is high variance in between both of them. But when we apply multiple decision tree, then there is a low variance in between these our actual target variable and our predicted target variable by our model. That's why we use random forest for better model, better learning understanding of our model, and we obtain model with low bias and high variance. That's why we use random forest. This is the required algorithm for our random forest. So thank you all of you. May all of you like this tutorial. Please subscribe our channel. Thank you all of you.